Second private member's bill, animal protection in relation to hares bill, 2015. I call on Deputy Maureen O'Sullivan to move for leave to introduce the bill.
I move. Okay. Right, I'm standing here today as the late Tony Gregory did in 1993 when he introduced a private member's bill on wildlife to ban hare coursing. And he spoke then, and I quote, "the welfare of the vulnerable and defenceless in nature's creation." And while greyhounds today are muzzled, the cruelty does continue for the hares. And that is why this bill I'm proposing that it won't be lawful to engage in live hare coursing. Hare coursing involves the terrorising of one animal by another. It causes unnecessary cruelty every year to thousands of hares through stress, injury and death. It's a total contradiction to me that on the one hand, the hare is protected under the Wildlife Act, but the Act also protects hare coursing, saying it's illegal to trap and sell hares other than for the specific purpose of coursing them. So on the one hand, the hare is protected, except when it comes to coursing. Now, what's involved in coursing? The procedures. Well, sometime before each coursing meeting, the club members go out in... Sorry, Ken Corlett, the clock isn't going.
No, yeah, okay.
Clock. I just noticed,
yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. You're all right. I'll let you finish your
little Okay, thank you. The club members go out into the countryside to collect the hares in a process that's known as netting. They shout and they yell as they herd the hares into the net. And then the hares are put into boxes to be transported to the coursing venue. Netting and handling are cruel. Netting an animal that is used to the freedom of nature, and the hare is a very timid and a delicate creature. Hares have been injured and have died in this process. And then there's the training of hares, and this has to happen to produce what's called better sport. So the hares are familiarised in the field so that when the coursing does happen, they will run up the centre of the field, which makes for good coursing. And then in those few weeks before the actual coursing event, they are kept herded in an enclosure, which is more stress and cruelty because hares are strictly are solitary creatures and they don't live together in groups. And during those weeks of being herded, they're very prone to disease, which spreads very quickly due to them being enclosed. There's absolutely no doubt that the practice of blooding continues. Often it's hares, but other times it's rabbits and kittens. There are greyhound owners who are against coursing, but they have to register with the Irish Coursing Club, which skews the level of support for coursing, because so many surveys, independent surveys and opinion polls indicate that people are opposed to coursing. And that's not confined to urban Ireland, because I know there are cases in urban Ireland of cruelty to animals, but there are people in rural Ireland who do not like this practice of coursing. All the animal welfare organisations are opposed to live hare coursing, and there are only three countries in Europe, and Ireland is one of those which allows it. What coursing is about in both open and enclosed coursing is hares running for their lives. The hare doesn't know that the greyhound is muzzled and that it can't be killed. Now, both Deputy Clare Daly and I have brought up a number of issues relating to this. Now, recently this morning with Minister Humphreys, Deputy Daly was pointing out, which I have as well also, that there have been breaches to the licences granted to the coursing clubs. But what happens? Do they get a slap on the wrist? Do they get a fine? Is their licence revoked? No, they continue to get the licence. And what we're told is that the welfare issues are a matter for the Department of Agriculture. Now, I believe if there are breaches of licences and the conditions, surely the logical conclusion is that a licence won't be granted. If a pub or a restaurant or a nightclub breached licensing conditions, their licence would be revoked. Some months ago, the weather prevented the last day of a coursing event, and it is acknowledged that it was being monitored, so the ground was unsuitable. Instead of it being a reprieve for the hares, they were kept in captivity for a further week until the weather improved. Now, this is not about destroying the greyhound industry. It's about using live hares in this cruel way, which has led to injury and death, as documented by the National Parks and Wildlife Service. And there have been occasions when their work has been intimidated and they've been inhibited from doing their work by coursing enthusiasts. This is a very clearly defined remit. There is an alternative to live hare coursing. In Australia and the United States, they have drag coursing. I don't understand the attraction for men, and it's mainly men, who get pleasure in seeing a defenceless animal running for its life. Now, there's also injuries to the greyhounds, and we know what happens to greyhounds who don't reach the mark. in either coursing or racing, unless, of course, they are rescued by animal welfare people. Because the greyhound also is a gentle creature until it's introduced to blooding for coursing. And this is certainly one occasion, and there have been others, when I do wish Deputy Peter Matthews' bill had come in, because I don't believe the majority in this House are in favour of coursing. So I look forward, if my bill is taken out, if it does go ahead, that we can have a full and frank debate on this very cruel practice.
Thank you. Is the bill being opposed? No, not opposed. I declare the motion for leave to introduce agreed, since this is a private member's bill. Second stage must, understanding orders, be taken in private member's time. So I'd ask the deputy to move that the second stage be taken.
I move.
Is that agreed?
Agreed.